my soul praise him, for he is thy health and salvation. All ye who hear, now to his temple draw near. Join me in glad adoration. Praise to the Lord who o'er all things so wondrously reigneth. Shelters thee under his wings, yes, so gently sustaineth. Hast thou not seen how all thy longings have been? Praise to the Lord who doth prosper thy work and defend thee. Surely his goodness and mercy here daily attend thee. Ponder anew what the Almighty can do. If with his love he befriend thee, let all that is in me adore him. All that have life and breath, come now with praises before him. Let the amen sound from his people again. Gladly for
good morning, my name is Maynard Pittendreigh. I am the pastor of College Park Presbyterian Church. Welcome to our online worship service. Hear the word of Psalm 96. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Let us worship the Lord our God.
Creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice amid the sea. Oh, praise him, alleluia. Thou burning sun with golden gleam, thou silver moon with softer gleam. Praise him, hallelujah.
Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty God, you have raised Jesus Christ from death to life and crowned him Lord of all. We confess that we have not bowed down before him or acknowledged his rule in our lives. We have gone along with the ways of the world and have failed to give him glory. Forgive us and raise us from sin, that we may be your faithful people, obeying the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, who rules the world and is the head of the church, his body. In the glory of his name we pray, amen. My friends, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our faults, God is faithful and just and will forgive us of all of our sins and cleanse us from unrighteousness. This is the good news of the gospel. Therefore, let us sing glory to God.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. Oh, my soul, praise him, for he is thy health and salvation. All ye who hear, now to his temple draw near. Join me in glad adoration.
You know, so often when we think of the church, we think of the building, but the building is not the church. It's a place where the church meets. And if we have learned anything as a church in the pandemic, it is that. Our church is still a strong community of fellowship and love for one another, and we are still doing the work of the Lord. And so I invite you to remember the Lord Jesus Christ and how he said it is more blessed to give than to receive, and to share your tithes and offerings at this time. We cannot pass the plate, but we know the routine by now. You can send your checks through the mail. You can send your funds online. The information you see is on the screen. Let us join our voices together in prayer. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for all of the blessings that you've given us in this life. And we pray that you would bless the offerings and tithes that we share at this time, that they may be a blessing to those in need. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray, amen.
Shall be forever Jesus, my firm foundation in shifting sands, my strength and hope through many fears and failures, the disappointments of the past. His constant love has held me fast. So for all my days, I will sing my praise to the King forever, Jesus. Though the storms may rage, he is strong to save. He's the King forever, Jesus. My song of joy shall be forever Jesus, who bore suffering, who made a way. His life a gift, his death a precious ransom that wipes the sinner's guilt away and turns our night to glorious day. So for all my days I will sing my praise to the King forever, Jesus. Though the storms may rage, He is strong to save. He's the King forever, Jesus. Shall be forever, Jesus, when shadows lengthen before my eyes. My Lord and friend, companion through the valley, when dearest ones are left behind. His hand will lead me to so for all my days, I will sing my praise to the King forever, Jesus. Though the storms may rage, He is strong to save. He's the King forever, Jesus. When I meet His gaze, I will sing my praise to the King forever, Jesus. All my sorrows past, I am home at last with my King forever, Jesus. With my King forever, Jesus. With my
to the Lord God in prayer. And as we do, let me invite you to use the chat room on the YouTube that you can share your own prayer concerns with others. Or if you would prefer, you can text me or email the church office. When the church office receives them, they will share your prayer requests with me and also with prayer groups in the church. There are people who want to join with you in your concerns and to lift you up in prayer. We are not alone in this pandemic time, so let's break through the walls that are created by this virus and reach out spiritually to one another. Let's pray together. O God, you are the author of peace and the lover of concord, and knowledge of you stands our eternal life. In your service we find perfect freedom. Defend us in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your Spirit, may not fear the power of any adversary. O Lord, our governor, whose glory is in all the world, we commend this nation to your merciful care, that being guided by your providence, we may dwell secure in your peace. Grant to the President of the United States and all in authority wisdom and strength to know and to do your will. Fill them with the love of truth and righteousness, and make them ever mindful of their calling to serve you and your people. O God, you are the creator and preserver of all humanity. We humbly pray for all sorts and conditions of men and women. that you would make your ways known to them. More especially, we pray for your Holy Church Universal, that it may be so guided and governed by your good Spirit, that all who profess and call themselves Christians may be led into the way of truth and hold the faith in the unity of spirit and in the bond of peace. Finally, we commend to your godly care all those who are in any way afflicted or distressed in mind, body, or spirit. We pray for those who are ill and undergoing treatment. We pray for those whose families are in crisis. We pray for the unemployed and the underemployed. We pray for those who are anxious, lonely, or afraid. We pray for those who do not feel that they are loved. Gracious Lord, these are our common concerns, and we lift them up to you in the name of Christ. And silently, we lift up our private concerns to you in prayer. And now together we join our voices as one as we continue to address you as our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Most of you know that in addition to being the pastor of College Park Presbyterian Church, I'm an astronomer, and I enjoy astronomy, and I have my entire life, and I want to share some spiritual lessons that astronomy has taught me. Lesson number one, enjoy the beauty of God's creation. Now, you can do that whether you're an astronomer or not. I know that we have bird watchers in our church, and we have people who enjoy hiking. We enjoy people who go to national parks and state parks. People who enjoy fishing and just like to be out on the water. Psalm 19 says, "The heavens are declaring the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day to day pours forth speech, and night to night declares knowledge. There is no speech, there are no words, their voice is not heard, yet their voices go out through all the earth, and their words to the end of the world. In the heavens he has set a tent for his son." What a wonderful passage. Psalm 8, the psalmist says, "When I consider the stars and the skies, what is a human being that you're mindful of him? And yet you've made people just a little less than angels." Several years ago, NASA had to send the space shuttle mission to the Hubble Space Telescope for one last repair mission. The space shuttle program was winding down, and the Hubble Space Telescope was scheduled to be decommissioned as well. But there was public outrage. We wanted the Hubble Space Telescope to continue to do its work. Now, why did we want that? Most people didn't understand the science involved in the Hubble Space Telescope. I'm an astronomer, and I barely knew the science discoveries that were being made. What people wanted was to enjoy the photographs, the beauty of the universe, the beauty of God's creation. Hubble Space Telescope opened us wonders in the sky. This is a photograph that I've taken of a planetary nebula a star that used to be there that has now exploded. It's a beautiful sight. You can barely see it in this photograph. After hours and hours at work, I've been able to bring out more of the beauty of that nebula. And then after taking hundreds and hundreds of photographs and stacking them on top of each other in a film processing procedure, I bring out more of the beauty. But you look at the Hubble Space Telescope and wow! People talk about this is the eye of God. Enjoy the beauty, and I don't care whether you're an astronomer or not, learn that lesson to enjoy the beauty of God's creation. Now, spiritual truth number two, change. Spiritual truth number two, change. Change happens whether we like it or not. Our church is going through changes. And our lives are going through changes. This pandemic has changed everything. In fact, some of us want more changes to come. We want to get back to normal. Before, it was with all these changes of masks and things like that. I've often heard it said that people don't like change, and I do not believe that that's true. We love to see new television shows and new movies and read new books. A new restaurant comes to town, we can't wait to go and try it. We like new things. What we don't like is the loss of the familiar things. Give us a new program we've never seen on television and we'll watch it. But don't take away those 50-year-old Andy Griffith shows with Barney and Aunt Bee. We like those as well. Don't take away the familiar. We like new restaurants, but don't take away the old favorites. The church, we know we need to change, and we need to be open to that. But don't take away the love and the community that we find at College Park. And one of the great accomplishments of the pandemic is that we've maintained that community. And if you don't feel that community, please, come back and join us for the worship, the Zoom, the Sunday school. Contact me and we'll make sure that you feel a part of that community again. The scripture teaches us about change, the inevitability of it. Isaiah 43 says, "Behold, I'm doing a new thing, and now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and in the desert." Now, astronomy teaches me about change. Every so often, there's something brand new that I've never seen. I've seen and photographed almost 1,000 comets since 1965. And some of these you can barely see through the telescope. But some of them have beautiful tails and beautiful shapes and sizes. And one day, I was able to photograph this planetary nebula called the Ring Nebula as a comet was in the same field of view. It's a rare event to see a comet in the same field of view of a telescope as something else, like a planet or a nebula. And I photographed it. It was here today and gone the next day. Change is all around us. Change happens all the time. And one of the interesting things about Saturn is the rings. And the thing about the rings of Saturn is they change all the time. Every 11 years, we are in the same plane, Earth and the rings of Saturn, and the rings disappear. But over a period of time, those rings come and go and are inclined in a different way. And it looks like every night is worth looking at. Change happens constantly. There's a star that I look at. I've been photographing it for about 30 or 40 years. And we think that the stars never change. But the stars change constantly. And they move. The thing is, they move generally in the same direction and at the same speed. But Cepheid's star is a star that is going against the grain, moving in a different direction than other stars, probably because it had a close encounter with a star
millions of years ago, and its course was disturbed. But over a period of time, you can see that star moving and moving. It's fast. Over a day or two, you can't see it. Over a year, you can't see it. But over 2, 3, 10 years, it becomes visible. Change happens. Change happens in your life, and it happens in the church, and it happens in your family. And you have to accept that, behold, God is doing a new thing. Now, another spiritual truth that astronomy has taught me, wait for it. You cannot rush the blessings of God. God works in His time, and His time only. Now, in the scripture, it teaches us in Ecclesiastes 3, and you probably know this, there is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to cry and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. Now that part sounds like the pandemic, social distances, refrain from embracing, a time to search and a time to give away and give up, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to mend, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. Whatever time it is, you cannot rush these things. God's plan unfolds at God's speed. We need to get used to that. Churches without a pastor sometimes are in a rush getting the next pastor. And sometimes they rush too quickly. On the other hand, and this I think is more likely in the Presbyterian church, we take too much time and we need to get to work. We can't delay it. We can't rush it. In astronomy, there's an event called the total solar eclipse. Now, these are beautiful to see, but you can't rush this. If you arrive at the place where you want to observe the eclipse, you can't start it. You have to wait for God to start it. And the moon begins to move between Earth and the sun on the same plane, so that it blocks out part of the sun, and it slowly, slowly moves across the face of the sun until all of a sudden, for 3 or 7 minutes, there's a total eclipse. And the moon is right in front of the sun. And it blocks out everything except the corona, the outer atmosphere of the sun. And these are beautiful events, but you can't rush them. They will happen in their own good time. And that's the way it is with our lives. You can't rush the blessings of God. They will come. You can't rush this pandemic being over with. We can do our part. We can wear masks, wash our hands, get our vaccinations. But in God's time, it will happen. As surely as a solar eclipse will occur, it will happen. The next spiritual truth is this: what you cannot see is still there, and what seems distant is still with us. Astronomy has taught me that very clearly. Hebrews 11 says, "Now faith is the confidence in what we hope for and the assurance of what we do not see." You may know the constellation Orion. It's a very familiar constellation. It's in the skies right now in the early evenings. You can go out there and you can see the familiar three stars of the belt of Orion, the sword of Orion, the stick figure of a man, a hunter, and They're just stars. But if you have a telescope or a camera that you can expose to that constellation for a long time, then you can see gas, nebulae throughout Orion. And on the belt of Orion, there is this beautiful object called the Horsehead Nebula. Because you can see, if you've got the imagination, the silhouette of a horse's head. It's a beautiful nebula. I have photographed this probably well over 100 times, but I've never seen it. In part because of light pollution, it has to be a very, very dark area. But even when I go to a dark site, my eyes, which are not as young as they used to be, cannot even see a glimpse of this nebula. But I know exactly where it is, and I can photograph it, and then I can see it on the camera. Astronomy has taught me that sometimes you cannot see things, but the evidence is there, and the object is there. I have never seen the face of God, but the evidence is there. The evidence that I see in nature, not only in astronomy, but by watching the birds and the squirrels play at my bird feeder, to see my grandson growing up, I see the hand of God. To see the people of this church working together and caring for each other, that's the hand of God. And sometimes, especially in a situation like the pandemic, God seems distant. He seems invisible. We don't see him. And simply because we do not see him does not mean that he is not there. Mother Teresa, one of the great saints of the church, we think, well, she would never have any doubts about God, but she did. And these were revealed in letters that were published after her death. She had entrusted them in the care of her mentor priests, and they published them after her death. They gave insight to the fact that for great periods of time, she did not feel the presence of God at all. And you know what she kept doing? She kept doing the work of God. Even when God seemed distant and she could not see him, she knew with her mind that God was still there. My friends, know that while you cannot see God, he's like the Horsehead Nebula. He's still there. The evidence is there. You may not see him or feel him at times, but my friends, have faith. And now unto God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be ascribed all might, power, dominion, and glory, today and forever. Amen.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. Son not sparing, standing to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sing
soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
My friends, at this time I invite you to look to the words of the Apostles' Creed. Not only as a tool for proclaiming your faith, but also during this time of pandemic to remind us of what it is that we believe. My friends, what do you believe? I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
World, and to my listening ears, all nature sings, and round me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world. This is my Father's world. The birds their carols raise, the morning light, the lily white, declare their Maker's praise. This is my Father's world. He shines in all that's fair. In the rustling grass I hear him pass. He speaks to me everywhere. This is my Father's word. Oh, let me near forget that though the wrong seems oft so strong, God is the my Father's word. Why should my heart be sad? The Lord is King. Let the heavens ring. God reigns. Let the earth be glad. The Lord is King.
And now may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord smile on you, shine His light upon you. May the Lord lift you, turn His face towards you, give you His peace, give you His peace.